Yo, what's up? Have you ever felt like KQL is kind of keeping you away from the real-time intelligence fun because it's a new language and something you have to learn? Well, straight off the press from FabCon Vienna, we have a solution now, and it's called the MCP Server for real-time intelligence. So what the MCP Server does for us is that it translates our natural language questions into KQL queries that goes and runs towards the event house. So we are gonna install the MCP Server. We're gonna test it out to see how this actually works. But you know what? Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my laptop. If we start with the actual Fabric real-time intelligence MCP server documentation and scroll down a little bit, you're gonna see here that we have full open source MCP server implementation. So if we go and click on that one, it's gonna send us to a GitHub page, and this is where we can find the how-tos on how to actually install this MCP server. So if we scroll down a bit here, it says getting started. So we first of all need to have Visual Studio Code installed. And then we also need to install the GitHub Copilot chat if you haven't already. And then also we need to install this PowerShell module here. It's gonna help us run a Python package instantly without installing it globally or messing with virtual environments. And then also we need to open VS Code from an empty folder. Okay, so what we're gonna do is I'm gonna open up Visual Studio Code, and I've already opened up a folder here, MCP demo. This was an empty folder when I first opened it. And as you can see, I already have the chat installed. And what I did actually the first time, I pasted this Python package here and hit enter. And then you're gonna install this module that we need. And then when you've done that, the next step is to actually install the MCP server. So we do that by following these steps here. So what we do is that we go into Visual Studio Code. And if you click Control Shift P, you're going to open up this command line tool here, and then you can start typing in MCP add server. So you see it already pops up here for me because I already did this. Click on that one. And now the next step is to choose the pip package. That's what we want to install. Then we need to give it the actual package name. If we go back here, you see that that's the Microsoft Fabric RTI MCP. So let's type that in here, hit enter. Then, you know, you want to allow it to be installed. And then we have to enter the server ID. So that's going to be Fabric RTI MCP. Hit enter again. And then it's going to ask, okay, do you want to install it globally or locally? You do what works for you. And when you have done that, you're gonna see that you get this mcp.json file here that's gonna be inside of your empty folder, and we get this script right here saying that we have an MCP server up and running. So as you see, I've already started it by hitting run. And if we now go over to the chat on the right hand side here, you see that we have the mcp.json file as part of our chat, meaning that the MCP server is connected to the chat and is ready to be used. I'm gonna go and expand this page here. And if we click on the tools down here, you're actually gonna see that these are all the tools that we have inside this chat. And if we scroll down here, you see that we have the MCP server with all the different tools that we can take advantage of. Now, the point here is that I can just ask it questions in English, and then it's going to understand and help me translate to run some queries. So let's just start with something simple. List all my custo databases. Hit enter. Now, it could prompt you to authenticate, and then it's going to open up a new web page, and it's going to say, please log in with your user. And then the MCP server is then going to make sure that it's only querying stuff that I am allowed to see already. Now, I already did sign in, so that's fine. And here you see it's listing my databases. Let's then ask it to summarize the data in my Contoso sales database. Let's see what it answers. Okay, so first of all, it's exploring the Contoso sales database. It's checking the entities. Then it's examining the schemas. It's actually picking up some sample data to better understand the context. And then diving into more details here. Okay, so now it's providing us a reply. In the Contoso sales database, we have sales fact, products, customers. Okay, cool. There's a sales overview. It's actually giving me some KPIs here on the total sales, total cost, and so on. And also giving me some information on the data models with a star schema. Okay, that's interesting. Well, what if I wanted to know something about how did we perform on, I don't know, the top selling product for 2008? Let's see if it understands that. It is actually taking then the context of this chat and saying, okay, let me check out the sales fact table. And it's telling me that the product anti-washer and dryer was really popular with more than 1,000 units sold. Cool. Okay, so it's giving me some information, telling me stuff. The best part is I didn't have to write any KQL to do this. Wow, that was kind of cool. What do you think about this? Is this something you're gonna use? Have you already tried this in your organization? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, hit the like button. And also remember to check out all the other awesome videos from Adam, Patrick, and myself. And we will see you guys in the next video. Bye!